Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are taking a good care of yourself. So, children, let us start today's mathematics class of grade 10th. This is class 10th, subject mathematics, chapter number 15, probability, lecture number 4. And children, content I am going to cover from your textbook, that is NCERT. Okay, children, in my previous lecture, we started with the Hodes question of exercise 15.2, right? So, the topics which I am going to cover in today's lecture, that is lecture number 4, that is number 1, I will be making you recall the theoretical definition of probability, and after that, I will be proceeding with Hodes questions from exercise 15.2. which is an optional exercise of NCERT. Fine, students? So, children, let us quick give a recall to the theoretical definition of probability. That is, probability of an event is equal to number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. Let us understand it through one example. When a die is thrown, you know that there will be total 6 possible outcomes. So let E be the event of getting the digit 4. So children, can you tell me how many times 4 will occur when you are going to throw the die once? Of course, it will occur one time only. So then the favorable outcome to the event E will be only 1. And according to the formula of probability, the probability of the event must be equal to 1 upon 6. Why 6? Because 6 is total number of possible outcomes. As you know that in a die, the number starts from 1 and goes up to 6. Understood? Now children, I am going to begin with the Hodes questions of exercise 15.2. Question number 1 was discussed with me in my previous lecture that I explained to you. Okay, now I am going to switch to question number 3. Question number 2 is very simple. The concept which is covered in question number 2, that also I have taught you in my previous lectures. So that would be included in your maths homework. Fine, children? So this is question number 3, the very first, or I should say the second Hodes, but the very first Hodes of today's lecture. A bag contains 5 red balls and some blue balls. We do not know the number of blue balls, but here it is defined that number of red balls is equal to 5. If the probability of drawing a blue ball is double that of a red ball, then determine the number of blue balls in the bag. Got it? So let us have a look on its solution. How to do it, children? First of all, as you know that we will have to calculate the number of blue balls. So let us consider it. Let the number of blue balls is equal to x. Number of red balls, you know, that is 5. So can you tell me how many total balls will be there? Correct. So the total number of balls is equal to 5 plus x. So children, this 5 plus x will become our total number of possible outcomes. Got it? So this is possible outcomes. Now, according to question, it is said if the probability of drawing a blue ball. So first of all, we will have to calculate the probability of drawing a blue ball. You know how many blue balls are there? Number of blue balls is equal to x. So this x will become the favorable outcome of blue balls. The formula for probability is number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes, means total number of possible outcomes. So through that I have calculated the probability of drawing blue ball. It would be x upon 5 plus x. Correct? So this probability is double of, that is twice of, the probability of the red ball. Now children, how many red balls are there? 5. So what will be the favorable outcomes? The number of favorable outcome, that will be 5. So the probability of red ball will be 5 upon total number of possible outcomes, that is 5 plus x. Correct? So this is an equation formed. Either you can solve it like 2 into 5, it would become 10 upon 5 plus x. Then while cross multiplying also you can solve it. Or I found the easiest alternate for it, that when I am going to bring this 5 plus x on left hand side, they both will be cancelled. So I have just cancelled them here only. Got it? So x is equal to 10. So the number of blue balls will be equal to 10. Clear? Okay. Now here is our next question, that is question number 4. It is again Hort's question. Please be alert. A box contains 12 balls. So how many balls are contained by a box? That is 12. Means these are total number of balls. Correct? Out of which x are black in color. Out of these 12 boxes, the number of black balls is equal to x. If one ball is drawn at random, means one ball is picked at random from that box, what is the probability that it will be a black ball only? So children, let us discuss it right now. You know that the number of black balls is equal to x. So that will be the favorable outcome for the event in which we want that the ball should be of black color. So x will be favorable outcome divided by total number of balls, that is 12. So x upon 12 will be the probability to get the black ball. So we have solved one part orally. Correct? Now, if 6 more black balls are put in the box. Now you tell me, if there were 12 balls earlier, 6 more are added. So now the total has become 18. Correct? And they all are black in color. Earlier the black balls number was x. So when 6 more will be added, it would become x plus 6. Yes or no? Correct? Now the probability of drawing a black ball means now probability. Now the new one you have to talk about. This is now double of that whatever was calculated earlier. So we are going to calculate the value of x. So this is all about understanding of the question. Now I will be showing you its solution. So children, here is the solution. Number of black balls is given to us, that is x. Total number of balls is also given to us, that is 12. So the probability of drawing a black ball is equal to number of black balls upon total number of balls. This is not essential that you should change the formula in this way. You could write that number of black balls is nothing but the number of favorable outcomes, and total number of balls is equal to total number of possible outcomes. Correct? So the same formula you could write here only also. So the probability to get a black ball will be x upon 12. That I have already explained you. Okay, orally also. Now, if 6 more black balls are put in the box, then the total number of black balls will become x plus 6. Explained just now. Fine. These I am talking about the total number of black balls. But if I am going to talk about the total number of balls, whether they are of some different color also, other than black color, so that would become 12 plus 6 is equal to 18. Clear or not? Fine. Now it is said in the question that when 6 more black balls are added in the box, then the probability, means the new probability which I am talking about, that is double of the probability which we calculated earlier, means this probability. Okay. So now let us calculate the probability of drawing a black ball on the basis of this data. It is favorable outcome, of course, because we are writing in the formula number of black balls upon total number of balls. So now the number of black ball is x plus 6 upon total number of balls has become 18 now. Clear? So children, according to question, the new probability which we have calculated when the number of black balls has been increased in the box, that is equal to x plus 6 upon 18. This probability is double, means it is twice. Of what? The probability which we calculated in case 1 when there was no black ball added in the box. Got it? So when this probability is double, so I have to make double to that probability which we calculated earlier so that both the expressions will become equal and a linear equation in one variable will be formed. Clear? As we are going to calculate the value of the variable x in this question. So this 2 and 12 are going to be cancelled. 2 ones are 2, 2 6 are 12. Clear? So children, what I have got here? Have a look. I have got x plus 6 upon 18 is equal to x upon 6. You can cancel it also. 6 ones are 6, 6 threes are 18. The choice is yours. Or you can go for the cross multiplication also. While cross multiplication, I got 6 in bracket x plus 6. So that would become 6x plus 36 is equal to 18 into x, that is 18x. Clear? Children, as I know that there is only one variable present in this equation, so this is known as linear equation in one variable. So we have to calculate the value of x. So this 6x will come on right hand side. It would become 18x minus 6x is equal to 12x. That is equal to 36. So x is equal to 36 divided by 12, that is 3. So what do we want basically? We wanted the value of x. And what was x, children? It was the number of black balls. So number of black balls is equal to x is equal to 3. Understood? Now children, this is the last hoards, or I should say the last question of this chapter from NCERT. Fine? So please be alert. Question number 5. A jar contains 24 marbles. How many marbles are contained by the jar? 24. Some are green in color and the others are blue in color. Out of these 24 marbles, some are green, some are blue. But we do not know the number of blue as well as the green marbles. Fine. According to this question, it is clear that some are green and others are blue. If a marble is drawn at random, randomly a marble is picked from the box, from the jar, then the probability that it is green is 2 by 3. Children, till now we were calculating the probability. But now here the probability is in our hand. So what is demanded in the question? Find the number of blue marbles in the jar. And we will be having the probability of green marbles given to us. So we are going to use the probability of green marbles to calculate the number of blue marbles. Got it? So children, here is the solution of question number 5. Total number of marbles are given to us, that is equal to 24. Fine. But how many are green out of those 24 and how many are blue? That is not specified in the question. So what can I do? As I have to calculate, I have to find out the number of the blue marbles. So definitely, I will have to assume either of the two marbles. Correct? Because I know the total number of marbles also. So let the number of green marbles is equal to x. If there are total 24 marbles in number, out of those x are green. So how many are left, children? Definitely 24 minus x. Please understand this concept. For example, I had 15 toffees. Out of those 15 toffees, I have given 5 toffees to my friend. So I am left with 15 minus 5, that is 10 trophies. The same concept we are going to apply over here. We had a total 24 marbles. Out of those 24 marbles, X are green in color. So X will be removed. Okay. So the number of blue marbles will become 24 minus X. Here many children remain confused. Fine. Basically, most of the time we used to subtract the value from the variable. But here we are going to subtract the variable from the value. Please children, make sure that the number of green balls will be lesser than the total number of balls, marbles. Why? Because blue marbles are also present over there. Clear children? So it will be 24 minus X. These are number of blue marbles. Clear? Okay. Now, as I told you when I was explaining you the statement that we are going to use the probability which is given to us of drawing green marble. Correct? So the probability of drawing a green marble is equal to, again, number of green marbles upon total number of marbles. Children, I repeat, you are not supposed to write down the formula in this way if you are not willing. You could write it in the theoretical manner also. What was that? Number of favorable outcomes upon total number of outcomes. But the need is that you should know how many are favorable. As I am going to calculate the probability of the green marble, so definitely children, X will be the favorable outcome in that case. Why? Because number of green marble is X. Clear? And total number of marbles are 24. So what would be the probability? It would be X upon 24. Correct? Which is already given to us in the question. X upon 24 is equal to 2 by 3. So this is the probability which I have calculated according to my assumption, and this is the probability which is given to me of drawing green marble. So definitely both the probabilities are related to the green marble, must be placed equal to each other. Correct? Now while cross multiplying, it would become 3x is equal to 24 into 2. So x is equal to 24 into 2 upon 3. 3 ones are 3. 3 8s are 24. So 8 into 2 will become 16. So children, we have calculated the value of X, that is 16. But what was X? X was the number of green marbles. But in the question, what is demanded? In the question, we are asked to calculate the number of blue marbles. So what is the number of blue marbles? This is 24 minus X. Correct? So here it is written that number of green marbles is equal to X is equal to 16 and number of blue marbles is equal to 24 minus X. Place the value of X over here. It would become 24 minus 16. That is equal to 8. Children, we can verify also whether we have reached on the right solution or not. See, 8 is the number of blue marbles, 16 is the number of green marbles. And how many are total marbles? 24. So 16 plus 8 will also become 24. Got it, children? Understood? So this was the last hoots as well as the last question of NCERT of chapter number 15, probability. Clear? I hope you all have understood whatever is taught today in today's lecture. Still, if you are left with any doubt or any query, then you can resolve those queries during live classes. Fine, children? Now, this is the time to get mathematics homework. Now, children, this is your mathematics homework. In my previous lecture, I gave you question till 21. Correct? 20th question was left to give you. Now, I am going to give you that question. So, do question 20th. 24 and 25 of exercise 15.1. Correct? Question number 2 of exercise 15.2, optional exercise in your maths homework notebook. Along with the classwork questions, children, what are classwork questions? These three hosts, question number 3 to question number 5 of exercise 15.2. These very questions you are supposed to do in your mathematics homework notebook. Fine, children? So that's it for the day. Please like the video and do not forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you and have a nice day.